DA, I'm from Milwaukee, Wisconsin.
I'm Max, I'm from Boston.
And we are Chester French.
So welcome. Why don't we start with you describing the sound of Chester French?
We like to make songs that are interesting musically and adventurous, but totally accessible from a pop standpoint.
Can you give me a word or phrase that defines your music?
I don't think we feel like limited by any number of adjectives.
Come on, guys. We need to classify you.
Right now, I think people are tired of being put in boxes. We were always guys who didn't necessarily fit into a certain group. We weren't like the punk kids, or we weren't the rock kids, or we weren't hip-hop guys or whatever. As we've thought about how to present ourselves and make the music, it's always been with the intention of making something that a lot of different kinds of folks can get into and understand and be welcome.
Well, she craves affection, so I use protection, and I know she loves me, she loves everybody, baby, oh no, oh yeah, darling, oh no, oh yeah, baby, oh.
Okay then, how did Chester French form?
We were freshmen at Harvard 5 years ago, met in the dining hall. We started a band with three of our classmates. Our sophomore year, pared it down to just the two of us. As Chester French, we've been working together for the past 4 years now.
You both produced and engineered this album. How did that come to be?
DA and I both got jobs engineering at an on-campus studio. We decided we both wanted to not feel limited by any guitar-based drums, keys type of instrumentation. It became a thing where the two of us were just in the studio all the time.
The group really came into its own as we were experimenting with how we could incorporate all these different influences into essentially 3-minute pop songs. We were, you know, applying sort of programmed drums and synthesizers and all this, but in a way that was more inspired by hip-hop records that we were really into. Should we just turn off phones and start over?
How did you get signed to his label?
It was a really nice accident that we ended up getting a record deal and being able to do this full time. But our intention had always been to put out this album we had finished, and that's how we even ended up meeting people like Pharrell. He extended us the opportunity to put out what we had made in its entirety, nothing more, nothing less.
That's sort of what we had been waiting for. Additionally, he offered us $10 million in a harem, which was nice.
Your music must be very good, considering the amount of press you have received.
We got the press for being handsome men. We've been in a lot of magazines, and it's strange because we haven't put a lot of music out, and you know, we're wondering like why. But then we realized, you know, Rolling Stone or Spin, one of them said we were an artist to watch. I think part of it is that we're both beautiful people, but I think really
beautiful men.
Beautiful men, yeah, winsome also.
Mm-hmm.
Now that we've made it this far. Now that we've made a mess in the car, you ought to give it a rest. But you feel so clean.
We've enjoyed doing everything ourselves, and we have never wanted to adulterate, I guess, the creative expression. And it was important to us that people's first exposure to us was with a record that was genuinely the product of our imagination and the product of our work and experimentation and fumbling around. And we're really excited to be able to put out that record that we always wanted to put out right now, exactly as we made it.
And I know she loves me.